So I'm back with another update to Winhance. This is Winhance release 15, version 26.01.19. So in this video, really quickly, I'm just going to take you through some of the changes that I've made. You can see all of the changes that I implemented on the screen here. And you can also go to the Winhance releases page and read every single one for yourself. But I just want to mention some of the most important or most notable changes that I've made in this update. First one being I added the legacy notepad to the legacy capabilities. And I updated the quick assist legacy name. So in Winhance here, you can see under the Windows capabilities, notepad is now listed with legacy. So it's different from the notepad that you'll find on Windows 11, which is the updated app introduced in Windows 11. This is the older legacy version. In previous versions of Winhance, the quick assist in the Windows capabilities had the exact same name as the quick assist in the Windows apps. And once again, the Quick Assist in Windows apps is a updated app compared to the Quick Assist in the Windows capabilities. One is a legacy app that was there in previous versions of Windows 11 and Windows 10. The naming scheme just changed a little bit so that it's clearer which of these apps are the new apps available on Windows 11 and which ones are the legacy apps. By putting it under the Windows capabilities heading here, I thought it would be clear enough. But in the end, it didn't turn out to be clear enough. So I just did the same what I did with Paint on the initial release of Winhance, where I marked it as legacy, because you also get the updated Paint app and then Paint 3D, which is retired. Next up, someone requested a feature to have Winhance remember the window size and position. So real quick, if I make Winhance really small, and just keep it to the right of the screen here, and I then close it and then reopen it, it's going to remember the size and the position that it was in on the screen before I closed it. So you'll see it opened to the middle and then immediately moved to the right on the exact same spot that I put it before closing the app. Then there was another name change where I renamed the Office Hub to MS365 Copilot, just like Microsoft did. So in the Windows apps and features here, you'll see MS365 Copilot, which was formerly known as Office Hub. So this was an Apex package that was always available in Windows, and it was retired at some stage, but it looks like Microsoft now reworked it to be the Microsoft 365 Copilot app. But on older versions of Windows, like Windows 10, for example, you might still see Office Hub as installed, although MS365 Copilot isn't installed. And that's because it was formerly known as Office Hub. So it uses the exact same AppX package ID as Office Hub, and that's why the name's been updated, but you can also see the legacy name that it used. Then I improved the logging for app installation checks. So there were many issues created saying that apps are showing up as installed, although they're not installed. And this mostly happens with Microsoft Edge and Microsoft OneDrive. So all of you guys who have issues with that, I've improved the logging so that we can see why it's detecting it as installed, although it's not installed. So I'll need to check the log files of this new version that's released if you guys still have those issues. So please create an issue if you still have false installation detections and provide the Winhance log file as well so that I can see why it's showing up as installed. Then I added desk flow to the external software section, which was also a feature request. And I also added the Copilot preview taskbar button toggle for supported builds only on Windows 11. So in Winhance, if you go over to the customize section, to the taskbar section, and you toggle the filter off, if you're not on Windows 11 23H2, you'll see this setting called Copilot preview button, where you can show or hide the Copilot preview button on the taskbar. Now, as far as I can tell, this was only on Windows 11 23H2. This is related to the Copilot preview button when Copilot was still in preview. It's not related to the Copilot button that you get in the latest builds like 24H2 and 25H2, because that's a different Copilot app. And the way you can remove that Copilot button is by just using the clean taskbar command up here in Winhance. So this Copilot preview button is only for the Windows 11 23H2 ISO file. Then some of the other changes are just related to adding missing localization keys and translations, resolving the power plan creation bug, and then also resolving the Windows Update DLL collision handling. And then there was also an issue with WimUtil, where the ISO extraction also captured the PowerShell profiles output, and in some cases people couldn't extract the ISO contents from the Windows ISO file, and that's also been fixed. But that's basically the gist of the 15th release of WinOnce, and if you don't mind, go ahead and download it, test it out. If you find any bugs, you can just click on the bug report icon inside of the application here. It'll take you straight to the issues page. You can create a new issue, but just check if there isn't already an existing issue on that specific problem that you have, and then I'll try and get back to you guys as soon as possible. But with all of that being said, thanks so much for checking out the app. Let me know your thoughts down in the comments below, and I'll talk to you guys soon.